South Dakota CDL tanker vehicles test.
Question 1. Hauling liquids in tankers requires special care for the following reason. S.
Liquid movement. Both of these answers are correct. High center of gravity.
Answer.
Both of these answers are correct.
Question 2. The amount of liquid to load into a tank depends on
the legal weight limits, the amount the liquid will expend in transit. Both of the above factors.
Answer.
Both of the above factors.
Question 3. You should be very cautious when driving smoothbore tankers, especially when you are
going uphill or downhill, driving against the wind, starting or stopping.
Answer.
Starting or stopping.
Question 4. When you load the small tanks of a cargo tank equipped with bulkheads, you should check the
distribution of weight, air to fuel ratio, water content.
Answer.
Distribution of weight.
Question 5. You need to be very careful when driving smoothbore tankers. This is especially true when you are
starting or stopping, hauling milk or other food products, loading and unloading.
Answer.
Starting or stopping.
Question 6. Liquid-tight separators between compartments inside tanks are called
baffles, bulkheads, barriers.
Answer.
Bulkheads.
Question 7. You should know the outage needed for the liquids you carry because
tank baffles are not always legal with outage. Some of the heaviest liquids do not need any outage. Some liquids expend more than others when they get warm.
Answer.
Some liquids expend more than others when they get warm.
Question 8. Side-to-side surge can cause
suspension system failure, overspeeding, a rollover.
Answer.
A rollover.
Question 9. What does liquid surge do to handling of a tanker?
Surge raises the wind drag of the truck. Surge lets you turn corners tighter. It can move the truck in the direction the liquid waves move.
Answer.
It can move the truck in the direction the liquid waves move.
Question 10. The best way to take a curve with a tanker is to slow to a safe speed before entering the curve. Then, as you go through it,
brake lightly, speed up slightly, downshift twice.
Answer.
Speed up slightly.
Question 11. You should be very cautious when driving smoothbore tankers, especially when you are
going uphill or downhill, driving against the wind, starting or stopping.
Answer:
starting or stopping.
Question 12. You are driving a tanker truck. The front wheels begin to skid. Which of these is most likely to occur?
You will continue in a straight line and keep moving forward no matter how you steer. The truck will roll over. Liquid surge will pull the tank from the truck.
Answer:
you will continue in a straight line and keep moving forward no matter how you steer.
Question 13. Hauling liquids in tank vehicles requires special care for two reasons.
Liquid movement. Extreme weight. Uneven expansion.
Answer:
liquid movement.
Question 14. You need to be very careful when driving smoothbore tankers. This is especially true when you are
starting or stopping, loading and unloading, hauling milk or other food products.
Answer:
starting or stopping.
Question 15. The amount of liquid to load into a tank depends on
the legal weight limits, the amount the liquid will expand in transit, both of the above factors.
Answer:
both of the above factors.
Question 16. Outage means
how fast the liquid tanks drain, liquid weight, allowance for expansion of liquid.
Answer:
allowance for expansion of liquid.
Question 17. The liquid in a tank with baffles can still have what kind of surge?
Side to side, top to bottom, front to back.
Answer:
side to side.
Question 18. Baffles in liquid cargo tanks do not usually prevent surge.
Top to bottom, side to side, front to back.
Answer:
side to side.
Question 19. When you unload the smaller tanks or a tank with bulkheads, be careful to check your
air to fuel ratio, water content, distribution of weight.
Answer:
distribution of weight.
Question 20. Side-to-side surge can cause
suspension system failure, overspeeding, a rollover.
Answer:
a rollover.
Question 21. Which of these statements about stopping distance and speed is true?
You need about 2 times as much stopping distance at 40 miles per hour as at 20 miles per hour. Wet roads can double stopping distance at any speed. Both of the above are true.
Answer.
Wet roads can double stopping distance at any speed.
Question 22. The amount of liquid to load into a tank depends on.
The amount the liquid will expend in transit. The legal weight limits. Both of the above factors.
Answer.
Both of the above factors.
Question 23. When your cargo tank has baffles, what handling effect do you expect?
There will be a slower surge than quick surge. There will be less front-to-back surge than there is for a tank. There will be less side-to-side surge than there is in a tank without baffles.
Answer.
There will be less front-to-back surge than there is for a tank.
Question 24. Empty trucks
may require a longer stopping distance than full trucks. Stop quicker when you use only the emergency or parking brake. Have better traction when stopping than full trucks.
Answer.
May require a longer stopping distance than full trucks.
Question 25. Liquid tight separators between compartments inside tanks are called.
Baffles. Barriers. Bulkheads.
Answer.
Bulkheads.
Question 26. The best way to take a curve with a tanker is to slow to a safe speed before entering the curve. Then, as you go through it,
brake lightly. Downshift twice. Speed up slightly.
Answer.
Speed up slightly.
Question 27. Separators, with openings or holes in them, that are between compartments in a tank are called.
Bulkheads. Barriers. Baffles.
Answer.
Baffles.
Question 28. How would you expect a truck with a cargo tank that has baffles to handle on the road?
The truck will seem heavier than it really is. There will be less front-to-back surge than there is in a tanker without baffles. The truck will handle the same as a tanker without baffles.
Answer.
There will be less front-to-back surge than there is in a tanker without baffles.
Question 29. You are driving on a clear night. You must dim your headlights from high to low. You should adjust your speed so that you can stop within.
The distance you will travel in the next 15 seconds. The length of your vehicle. The distance you can see ahead.
Answer.
The distance you can see ahead.
Question 30. Which of these statements about emergency steering and tankers is true?
A tanker is easier to countersteer than most vehicles. Use only the emergency brakes. You should wrap your thumbs around the steering wheel before starting a quick steering movement.
Answer.
Use only the emergency brakes.
Question 31. Side-to-side surge can cause
a rollover, overspeeding, suspension system failure.
Answer:
a rollover.
Question 32. Which of these statements about stopping distance and speed is true?
You need about 2 times as much stopping distance at 40 miles per hour as at 20 miles per hour. Wet roads can double stopping distance at any speed. Both of the above are true.
Answer:
wet roads can double stopping distance at any speed.
Question 33. How would you expect a truck with a cargo tank that has baffles to handle on the road?
There will be less front-to-back surge than there is in a tanker without baffles. The truck will handle the same as a tanker without baffles. The truck will seem heavier than it really is.
Answer:
there will be less front-to-back surge than there is in a tanker without baffles.
Question 34. When you load the small tanks of a cargo tank equipped with bulkheads, you should check the
air-to-fuel ratio, water content, distribution of weight.
Answer:
distribution of weight.
Question 35. When you unload the smaller tanks or a tank with bulkheads, be careful to check your
water content, distribution of weight, air to fuel ratio.
Answer:
distribution of weight.
Question 36. Hauling liquids in tankers requires special care for the following reason. S.
Both of these answers are correct. Liquid movement, high center of gravity.
Answer:
both of these answers are correct.
Question 37. Liquid tight separators between compartments inside tanks are called
baffles, barriers, bulkheads.
Answer:
bulkheads.
Question 38. Empty trucks
have better traction when stopping than full trucks. May require a longer stopping distance than full trucks. Stop quicker when you use only the emergency or parking brake.
Answer:
may require a longer stopping distance than full trucks.
Question 39. The amount of liquid to load into a tank depends on
the legal weight limits, the amount the liquid will expend in transit. Both of the above factors.
Answer:
both of the above factors.
Question 40. An emergency forces you to stop your tanker quickly or crash. You should
use controlled door stab braking. Use only the emergency brakes. Lock the brakes with a pedal and hold it there.
Answer.
Use control door stab braking.
Question 41. Side-to-side surge can cause.
Suspension system failure. Overspeeding. A rollover.
Answer.
A rollover.
Question 42. Side-to-side surge can cause.
Overspeeding. Suspension system failure. A rollover.
Answer.
A rollover.
Question 43. What does liquid surge do to handling of a tanker?
It can move the truck in the direction the liquid waves move. Surge lets you turn corners tighter. Surge raises the wind drag of the truck.
Answer.
It can move the truck in the direction the liquid waves move.
Question 44. Baffles in liquid cargo tanks do not usually prevent surge.
Top to bottom. Side to side. Front to back.
Answer.
Side to side.
Question 45. When you unload the smaller tanks or a tank with bulkheads, be careful to check your
air to fuel ratio, water content, distribution of weight.
Answer.
Distribution of weight.
Question 46. When you load the small tanks of a cargo tank equipped with bulkheads, you should check the
water content, distribution of weight, air to fuel ratio.
Answer.
Distribution of weight.
Question 47. Hauling liquids in tankers requires special care for the following reason. S.
High center of gravity. Both of these answers are correct. Liquid movement.
Answer.
Both of these answers are correct.
Question 48. An emergency forces you to stop your tanker quickly or crash. You should
use only the emergency brakes. Use control door stab braking. Lock the brakes with the pedal and hold it there.
Answer.
Use control door stab braking.
Question 49. Liquid tight separators between compartments inside tanks are called
bulkheads, barriers, baffles.
Answer.
Bulkheads.
Question 50. When you unload the smaller tanks or a tank with bulkheads, be careful to check your
air to fuel ratio, distribution of weight, water content.
Answer.
Distribution of weight.
Question 51. When your cargo tank has baffles, what handling effect do you expect?
There will be a slower surge than quick surge. There will be less front-to-back surge than there is for a tank. There will be less side-to-side surge than there is in a tank without baffles.
Answer.
There will be less front-to-back surge than there is for a tank.
Question 52. Which of these statements about stopping distance and speed is true?
You need about 2 times as much stopping distance at 40 miles per hour as at 20 miles per hour. Wet roads can double stopping distance at any speed. Both of the above are true.
Answer.
Wet roads can double stopping distance at any speed.
Question 53. Side-to-side surge can cause
a rollover, suspension system failure, overspeeding.
Answer.
A rollover.
Question 54. An emergency forces you to stop your tanker quickly or crash. You should
use only the emergency brakes. Use controlled door stab braking. Lock the brakes with the pedal and hold it there.
Answer.
Use controlled door stab braking.
Question 55. Hauling liquids in tank vehicles requires special care for 2 reasons.
Liquid movement. Uneven expansion. Extreme weight.
Answer.
Liquid movement.
Question 56. The amount of liquid to load into a tank depends on
the amount the liquid will expand in transit, the legal weight limits, both of the above factors.
Answer.
Both of the above factors.
Question 57. You are driving a tanker truck. The front wheels begin to skid. Which of these is most likely to occur?
You will continue in a straight line and keep moving forward no matter how you steer. The truck will roll over. Liquid surge will pull the tank from the truck.
Answer.
You will continue in a straight line and keep moving forward no matter how you steer.
Question 58. Outage means
allowance for expansion of liquid. How fast the liquid tanks drain. Liquid weight.
Answer.
Allowance for expansion of liquid.
Question 59. Which of these statements about emergency steering and tankers is true?
A tanker is easier to countersteer than most vehicles. You should wrap your thumbs around the steering wheel before starting a quick steering movement. Use only the emergency brakes.
Answer.
Use only the emergency brakes.
Question 60. Hauling liquids in tank vehicles requires special care for 2 reasons.
Extreme weight. Uneven expansion. Liquid movement.
Answer.
Liquid movement.
Question 6-1. The amount of liquid to load into a tank depends on
the amount the liquid will expend in transit, the legal weight limits, both of the above factors.
Answer.
Both of the above factors.
Question 62. The best way to take a curve with a tanker is to slow to a safe speed before entering the curve. Then, as you go through it,
brake lightly, downshift twice, speed up slightly.
Answer.
Speed up slightly.
Question 63. You need to be very careful when driving smoothbore tankers. This is especially true when you are
hauling milk or other food products, loading and unloading, starting or stopping.
Answer.
Starting or stopping.
Question 64. You are driving on a clear night. You must dim your headlights from high to low. You should adjust your speed so that you can stop within
the length of your vehicle, the distance you can see ahead, the distance you will travel in the next 15 seconds.
Answer.
The distance you can see ahead.
Question 65. When should the driver of a tanker that has lost its brakes use a truck escape ramp?
Only if the tank has baffles. Never. Always.
Answer.
Always.
Question 66. The liquid in a tank with baffles can still have what kind of surge?
Side to side. Top to bottom. Front to back.
Answer.
Side to side.
Question 67. When you unload the smaller tanks or a tank with bulkheads, be careful to check your
distribution of weight, water content, air to fuel ratio.
Answer.
Distribution of weight.
Question 68. You are driving a tanker truck. The front wheels begin to skid. Which of these is most likely to occur?
Liquid surge will pull the tank from the truck. The truck will roll over. You will continue in a straight line and keep moving forward no matter how you steer.
Answer.
You will continue in a straight line and keep moving forward no matter how you steer.
Question 69. An emergency forces you to stop your tanker quickly or crash. You should
use controlled door stab braking. Use only the emergency brakes. Lock the brakes with the pedal and hold it there.
Answer.
Use controlled door stab braking.
Question 70. The amount of liquid to load into a tank depends on
the amount the liquid will expend in transit, the legal weight limits, both of the above factors.
Answer.
Both of the above factors.
Question 71. Baffles in liquid cargo tanks do not usually prevent surge.
Front to back. Top to bottom. Side to side.
Answer.
Side to side.
Question 72. When you load the small tanks of a cargo tank equipped with bulkheads, you should check the
air to fuel ratio, distribution of weight, water content.
Answer.
Distribution of weight.
Question 73. When your cargo tank has baffles, what handling effect do you expect?
There will be a slower surge than quick surge. There will be less front-to-back surge than there is for a tank. There will be less side-to-side surge than there is in a tank without baffles.
Answer.
There will be less front-to-back surge than there is for a tank.
Question 74. Separators, with openings or holes in them, that are between compartments in a tank are called
bulkheads, baffles, barriers.
Answer.
Baffles.
Question 75. Liquid tight separators between compartments inside tanks are called
barriers, baffles, bulkheads.
Answer.
Bulkheads.
Question 76. The best way to take a curve with a tanker is to slow to a safe speed before entering the curve. Then, as you go through it,
speed up slightly. Downshift twice. Brake lightly.
Answer.
Speed up slightly.
Question 77. When should the driver of a tanker that has lost its brakes use a truck escape ramp?
Only if the tank has baffles. Always. Never.
Answer.
Always.
Question 78. Which of these statements about emergency steering and tankers is true?
Use only the emergency brakes. A tanker is easier to countersteer than most vehicles. You should wrap your thumbs around the steering wheel before starting a quick steering movement.
Answer.
Use only the emergency brakes.
Question 79. The amount of liquid to load into a tank depends on
the amount the liquid will expand in transit, the legal weight limits, both of the above factors.
Answer.
Both of the above factors.
Question 80. You are driving a tanker truck. The front wheels begin to skid. Which of these is most likely to occur?
The truck will roll over. You will continue in a straight line and keep moving forward no matter how you steer. Liquid surge will pull the tank from the truck.
Answer.
You will continue in a straight line and keep moving forward no matter how you steer.
Question 81. You need to be very careful when driving smoothbore tankers. This is especially true when you are
starting or stopping, hauling milk or other food products, loading and unloading.
Answer.
Starting or stopping.
Question 82. Baffles in liquid cargo tanks do not usually prevent surge.
Top to bottom, front to back, side to side.
Answer.
Side to side.
Question 83. The liquid in a tank with baffles can still have what kind of surge?
Front to back, side to side, top to bottom.
Answer.
Side to side.
Question 84. Empty trucks
may require a longer stopping distance than full trucks. Stop quicker when you use only the emergency or parking brake. Have better traction when stopping than full trucks.
Answer.
May require a longer stopping distance than full trucks.
Question 85. Hauling liquids in tank vehicles requires special care for two reasons.
Liquid movement, uneven expansion, extreme weight.
Answer.
Liquid movement.
Question 86. What does liquid surge do to handling of a tanker?
Surge lets you turn corners tighter. Surge raises the wind drag of the truck. It can move the truck in the direction the liquid waves move.
Answer.
It can move the truck in the direction the liquid waves move.
Question 87. Baffles in liquid cargo tanks do not usually prevent surge.
Side to side, front to back, top to bottom.
Answer.
Side to side.
Question 88. When your cargo tank has baffles, what handling effect do you expect?
There will be less front-to-back surge than there is for a tank. There will be a slower surge than quick surge. There will be less side-to-side surge than there is in a tank without baffles.
Answer.
There will be less front-to-back surge than there is for a tank.
Question 89. Which of these statements about stopping distance and speed is true?
Wet roads can double stopping distance at any speed. You need about 2 times as much stopping distance at 40 miles per hour as at 20 miles per hour. Both of the above are true.
Answer.
Wet roads can double stopping distance at any speed.
Question 90. An emergency forces you to stop your tanker quickly or crash. You should
use controlled doorstep braking. Use only the emergency brakes. Lock the brakes with the pedal and hold it there.
Answer.
Use control door stab braking.
Question 91. You should know the outage needed for the liquids you carry because
tank baffles are not always legal with outage. Some of the heaviest liquids do not need any outage. Some liquids expend more than others when they get warm.
Answer.
Some liquids expend more than others when they get warm.
Question 92. When you load the small tanks of a cargo tank equipped with bulkheads, you should check the
air to fuel ratio, distribution of weight, water content.
Answer.
Distribution of weight.
Question 93. Liquid tight separators between compartments inside tanks are called
bulkheads, barriers, baffles.
Answer.
Bulkheads.
Question 94. Side-to-side surge can cause
overspeeding, suspension system failure, a rollover.
Answer.
A rollover.
Question 95. Outage means
allowance for expansion of liquid, liquid weight, how fast the liquid tanks drain.
Answer.
Allowance for expansion of liquid.
Question 96. How would you expect a truck with a cargo tank that has baffles to handle on the road?
There will be less front-to-back surge than there is in a tanker without baffles. The truck will seem heavier than it really is. The truck will handle the same as a tanker without baffles.
Answer.
There will be less front-to-back surge than there is in a tanker without baffles.
Question 97. Separators, with openings or holes in them, that are between compartments in a tank are called
baffles, barriers, bulkheads.
Answer.
Baffles.
Question 98. Hauling liquids in tankers requires special care for the following reasons.
Both of these answers are correct. High center of gravity. Liquid movement.
Answer.
Both of these answers are correct.
Question 99. You are driving a tanker truck. The front wheels begin to skid. Which of these is most likely to occur?
You will continue in a straight line and keep moving forward no matter how you steer. Liquid surge will pull the tank from the truck. The truck will roll over.
Answer.
You will continue in a straight line and keep moving forward no matter how you steer.
Question 100. Which of these statements about emergency steering and tankers is true?
You should wrap your thumbs around the steering wheel before starting a quick steering movement. A tanker is easier to counter-steer than most vehicles. Use only the emergency brakes.
Answer.
Use only the emergency brakes.
Question 101. When should the driver of a tanker that has lost its brakes use a truck escape ramp?
Only if the tank has baffles. Never. Always.
Answer.
Always.
Question 102. Which of these statements about stopping distance and speed is true?
You need about 2 times as much stopping distance at 40 miles per hour as at 20 miles per hour. Wet roads can double stopping distance at any speed. Both of the above are true.
Answer.
Wet roads can double stopping distance at any speed.
Question 103. Which of these statements about emergency steering and tankers is true?
You should wrap your thumbs around the steering wheel before starting a quick steering movement. Use only the emergency brakes. A tanker is easier to counter-steer than most vehicles.
Answer.
Use only the emergency brakes.
Question 104. An emergency forces you to stop your tanker quickly or crash. You should
lock the brakes with the pedal and hold it there. Use only the emergency brakes. Use controlled doorstep braking.
Answer.
Use controlled doorstep braking.
Question 105. Side-to-side surge can cause
suspension system failure, a rollover, overspeeding.
Answer.
A rollover.
Question 106. When should the driver of a tanker that has lost its brakes use a truck escape ramp?
Only if the tank has baffles. Never. Always.
Answer.
Always.
Question 107. When your cargo tank has baffles, what handling effect do you expect?
There will be less side-to-side surge than there is in a tank without baffles. There will be less front-to-back surge than there is for a tank. There will be a slower surge than quick surge.
Answer.
There will be less front-to-back surge than there is for a tank.
Question 108. When you load the small tanks of a cargo tank equipped with bulkheads, you should check the
distribution of weight, air to fuel ratio, water content.
Answer.
Distribution of weight.
Question 109. The liquid in a tank with baffles can still have what kind of surge?
Side to side. Top to bottom. Front to back.
Answer.
Side to side.
Question 110. When should the driver of a tanker that has lost its brakes use a truck escape ramp?
Always. Never. Only if the tank has baffles.
Answer.
Always.
Question 111. The best way to take a curve with a tanker is to slow to a safe speed before entering the curve. Then, as you go through it,
brake lightly. Speed up slightly. Downshift twice.
Answer.
Speed up slightly.
Question 112. Outage means
how fast the liquid tanks drain. Allowance for expansion of liquid. Liquid weight.
Answer.
Allowance for expansion of liquid.
Question 113. Which of these statements about stopping distance and speed is true?
Wet roads can double stopping distance at any speed. You need about 2 times as much stopping distance at 40 miles per hour as at 20 miles per hour. Both of the above are true.
Answer.
Wet roads can double stopping distance at any speed.
Question 114. How would you expect a truck with a cargo tank that has baffles to handle on the road?
The truck will seem heavier than it really is. The truck will handle the same as a tanker without baffles. There will be less front-to-back surge than there is in a tanker without baffles.
Answer.
There will be less front-to-back surge than there is in a tanker without baffles.
Question 115. You should know the outage needed for the liquids you carry because
some of the heaviest liquids do not need any outage. Some liquids expand more than others when they get warm. Tank baffles are not always legal with outage.
Answer.
Some liquids expand more than others when they get warm.
Question 116. Hauling liquids in tankers requires special care for the following reason. S.
Both of these answers are correct. High center of gravity. Liquid movement.
Answer.
Both of these answers are correct.
Question 117. What does liquid surge do to handling of a tanker?
It can move the truck in the direction the liquid waves move. Surge raises the wind drag of the truck. Surge lets you turn corners tighter.
Answer.
It can move the truck in the direction the liquid waves move.
Question 118. Side-to-side surge can cause
a rollover, overspeeding, suspension system failure.
Answer.
A rollover.
Question 119. Which of these statements about emergency steering and tankers is true?
You should wrap your thumbs around the steering wheel before starting a quick steering movement. A tanker is easier to countersteer than most vehicles. Use only the emergency brakes.
Answer.
Use only the emergency brakes.
Question 120. When you unload the smaller tanks or a tank with bulkheads, be careful to check your
distribution of weight, water content, air to fuel ratio.
Answer.
Distribution of weight.
Question 121. You should be very cautious when driving smoothbore tankers, especially when you are
starting or stopping, driving against the wind, going uphill or downhill.
Answer.
Starting or stopping.
Question 122. An emergency forces you to stop your tanker quickly or crash. You should
use only the emergency brakes. Lock the brakes with the pedal and hold it there. Use controlled door stab braking.
Answer.
Use controlled door stab braking.
Question 123. You should know the outage needed for the liquids you carry because
tank baffles are not always legal with outage. Some liquids expend more than others when they get warm. Some of the heaviest liquids do not need any outage.
Answer.
Some liquids expend more than others when they get warm.
Question 124. Hauling liquids in tank vehicles requires special care for two reasons.
Uneven expansion. Liquid movement. Extreme weight.
Answer.
Liquid movement.
Question 125. The liquid in a tank with baffles can still have what kind of surge?
Side to side. Front to back. Top to bottom.
Answer.
Side to side.
Question 126. Which of these statements about emergency steering and tankers is true?
A tanker is easier to countersteer than most vehicles. You should wrap your thumbs around the steering wheel before starting a quick steering movement. Use only the emergency brakes.
Answer.
Use only the emergency brakes.
Question 127. You are driving on a clear night. You must dim your headlights from high to low. You should adjust your speed so that you can stop within
the length of your vehicle, the distance you can see ahead, the distance you will travel in the next 15 seconds.
Answer.
The distance you can see ahead.
Question 128. You should be very cautious when driving smoothbore tankers, especially when you are
going uphill or downhill, starting or stopping, driving against the wind.
Answer.
Starting or stopping.
Question 129. You are driving a tanker truck. The front wheels begin to skid. Which of these is most likely to occur?
Liquid surge will pull the tank from the truck. The truck will roll over. You will continue in a straight line and keep moving forward no matter how you steer.
Answer.
You will continue in a straight line and keep moving forward no matter how you steer.
Question 130. You should know the outage needed for the liquids you carry because
some liquids expend more than others when they get warm. Some of the heaviest liquids do not need any outage. Tank baffles are not always legal with outage.
Answer.
Some liquids expend more than others when they get warm.
Question 131. You are driving on a clear night. You must dim your headlights from high to low. You should adjust your speed so that you can stop within
the distance you can see ahead. The distance you will travel in the next 15 seconds. The length of your vehicle.
Answer.
The distance you can see ahead.
Question 132. When you load the small tanks of a cargo tank equipped with bulkheads, you should check the
air to fuel ratio, distribution of weight, water content.
Answer.
Distribution of weight.
Question 133. You are driving a tanker truck. The front wheels begin to skid. Which of these is most likely to occur?
Liquid surge will pull the tank from the truck. The truck will roll over. You will continue in a straight line and keep moving forward no matter how you steer.
Answer.
You will continue in a straight line and keep moving forward no matter how you steer.
Question 134. Empty trucks
have better traction when stopping than full trucks. Stop quicker when you use only the emergency or parking brake. May require a longer stopping distance than full trucks.
Answer.
May require a longer stopping distance than full trucks.
Question 135. Liquid tight separators between compartments inside tanks are called
bulkheads, baffles, barriers.
Answer.
Bulkheads.
Question 136. Outage means
how fast the liquid tanks drain. Allowance for expansion of liquid. Liquid weight.
Answer.
Allowance for expansion of liquid.
Question 137. When you unload the smaller tanks or a tank with bulkheads, be careful to check your
distribution of weight, water content, air to fuel ratio.
Answer.
Distribution of weight.
Question 138. Hauling liquids in tank vehicles requires special care for two reasons.
Uneven expansion. Liquid movement. Extreme weight.
Answer.
Liquid movement.
Question 139. You need to be very careful when driving smoothbore tankers. This is especially true when you are
loading and unloading, hauling milk or other food products, starting or stopping.
Answer.
Starting or stopping.
Question 140. You are driving on a clear night. You must dim your headlights from high to low. You should adjust your speed so that you can stop within
the distance you will travel in the next 15 seconds. The length of your vehicle. The distance you can see ahead.
Answer.
The distance you can see ahead.
Question 141. You should know the outage needed for the liquids you carry because
some liquids expand more than others when they get warm. Some of the heaviest liquids do not need any outage. Tank baffles are not always legal with outage.
Answer.
Some liquids expand more than others when they get warm.
Question 142. Hauling liquids in tank vehicles requires special care for two reasons.
Extreme weight. Uneven expansion. Liquid movement.
Answer.
Liquid movement.
Question 143. Which of these statements about stopping distance and speed is true?
You need about 2 times as much stopping distance at 40 miles per hour as at 20 miles per hour. Wet roads can double stopping distance at any speed. Both of the above are true.
Answer.
Wet roads can double stopping distance at any speed.
Question 144. Empty trucks
may require a longer stopping distance than full trucks. Have better traction when stopping than full trucks. Stop quicker when you use only the emergency or parking brake.
Answer.
May require a longer stopping distance than full trucks.
Question 145. When your cargo tank has baffles, what handling effect do you expect?
There will be a slower surge than quick surge. There will be less side-to-side surge than there is in a tank without baffles. There will be less front-to-back surge than there is for a tank.
Answer.
There will be less front-to-back surge than there is for a tank.
Question 146. Outage means
liquid weight. Allowance for expansion of liquid. How fast the liquid tanks drain.
Answer.
Allowance for expansion of liquid.
Question 147. The amount of liquid to load into a tank depends on
the amount the liquid will expand in transit. The legal weight limits. Both of the above factors.
Answer.
Both of the above factors. Thank you for watching the video and wish you will get your driver license soon.